Welcome back to Dreamin' Dragons. If you're a dragon fruit enthusiast, or maybe even if you aren't, there's a good chance you've seen lists of the hundreds of thousands of marginally different dragon fruit varieties. Oh, that one sounds cool. That sounds interesting. The name catches your eye, so you zoom in for a closer look, and you might see some abbreviations or fancy-sounding words. SS? SF? SP? Pardon? SelfSterile? SelfFertile? SelfPollinating? What's this all about? Today we're going to explain what these three acronyms or words mean, and why, if you're a new grower, this is something you should be looking out for. Plus, why if you're a seller or giving away a variety, this is important information to include. As you may well know, dragon fruit flowers open as the sun's setting and begin to close when the sun rises the next day. Short window for our bats, bees, ants and moths to get the business done. For the average backyard grower, reliance on our natural pollinators for our highly sought after fruit is risky and unreliable, particularly should cross-pollination be required. For our patience and hard work to be rewarded with an aborted flower can be incredibly heartbreaking, so having a clear understanding of our variety's fertility can make all the difference between fruit and newt. First, and most importantly, self-fertile. A self-fertile variety is a variety that will produce a fruit utilizing its own pollen. For the average punter or recreational gardener, I'd suggest these are the ones you look for when you first get started. Only need one variety, only need the one flower, and only need the one paintbrush. Oh yes, simples. Disclaimer, and a common misconception, just because it's a self-fertile variety doesn't mean it will set fruit without a little bit of help. The pollen still has to be delivered to the stigma, that little octopus thingo in the middle. Check out our flower anatomy video, I've linked in the description to get a closer look into the bits and bobs of the flower. Self-sterile. A self-sterile variety is one that will not produce a fruit utilizing its own pollen. You need to collect and transfer pollen from another variety onto the stigma of your flower for a fruit to set. This is also called cross-pollination. You will need at least two different varieties in your yard to set fruit with a self-sterile variety. The flower will yellow, dry up, and fall off if you use its own pollen or another flower of the same variety, regardless of whether it's grown in another pot or on another mother plant. While there are stacks of incredibly delicious and beautiful fruit that are self-sterile, if you're growing these plants for the fruit and don't have a second variety growing, or you can't be bothered collecting, storing, and cross-pollinating flowers, I'd suggest skipping on the self-sterile ones to save the disappointment. Self-pollinating. These are the bee's knees, the holy grail of dragon fruit varieties. These bad boys will not only set fruit with their own pollen, but they'll set a fruit without you lifting a finger. If you have a sticky beak inside a self-pollinating variety, you'll see the stigma is usually pretty short and resting among the anthers where our pollen's produced. Nature doing our work for us. Brilliant. Another cheeky disclaimer, for our self-fertile and our self-pollinating varieties, you'll find that hand-pollinating to get more pollen onto the stigma should lead to bigger fruit. Cross-pollinating these pups should also similarly bulk up your baby's size. Oh yes. So, to reiterate, self-fertile. Give it a dust with its own pollen and you'll get a fruit. Self-pollinating. Self-fertile will set a fruit on its own. Self-sterile will reject its own pollen and requires cross-pollination. And finally, if you've enjoyed or found this video interesting, please drop me a like as well as subscribing to my channel. It'll do wonders to help spread my content to the wider dragon fruiting community, plus will help you keep up to date with all the dragon fruity goodness we have going on here. Cheers, guys.